وصلي وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. ما بعد. We are talking about غزوة الحديبية. We mentioned one hadith where غزوة الحديبية, the place, and what was the number of the Muslimin in that غزوة, 1,400. And we mentioned the water finished, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, يعني because of his baraka, يعني the water was more than enough. He spit in the well of Hudaybiyah, then the water came out again. Then next hadith عن جابر رضي الله تعالى عنه قال قال أنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يوم الحديبية. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم told us or said to us, you are the best people on the earth. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said to 1,400 صحابي, you are the best people. So this is the guarantee from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Yes, خلاص. This hadith, this is one of the evidences. There are a lot of proofs that the Sahaba are the best. So this is very clear. أنتم خير أهل الأرض. You are the best people. And then Jabir رضي الله تعالى عنه said, we were 1,400. Not only four, 1,400. رضي الله تعالى عنه. وكنا 1,400. Jabir, when he was narrating this hadith, he was blind. Of course, this was, when he narrated this hadith, this is after the death of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. He was telling some of the tabi'in, so he was blind. Then he said, وَلَوْ كُنْتُ أُبْصِرُ الْيَوْمِ لَأَرَيْتُكُمْ مَكَانَ الشَّجَرَةِ. If I could see now, I would have shown you the place of the tree. They did bay'ah under the tree. So Jabir رضي الله تعالى said, if I can see now, I will show you where is the place of the tree. But subhanAllah, maybe at this time the tree was not there. Why? Because Umar, they mentioned the history, Umar رضي الله تعالى cut that tree because he noticed some of people went there. So he wants to stop the shirk. Or he wants to stop people before they do shirk. Yeah, subhanAllah, the shaitan will not come to you and will tell you, do shirk now. Step by step. Go and see the place. I want to see the place. I want, for example, people like to see Ghar Hira. Okay, just I want to see Ghar Hira. But subhanAllah, maybe when they go there, they feel, I want to pray there, two rak'ah. Why you pray to rak'ah in Ghar Hira? There is no evidence that praying there is better or there is a special reward. No. So subhanAllah, then they will enter in the bid'ah. Then after bid'ah, they will do shirk. Maybe they believe that we can take something from the stone or from the place. So subhanAllah, step by step. So many people will say, I want to see this place. This is the place of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. He was worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at that place. Okay. So you know. What the Sahaba رضي الله تعالى عنهم did after the birth of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, يعني after the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم became Prophet. Did he say to them, go to Ghar Hira? Did they go? خلاص. It is just a place. Nothing special in that place. So the same thing, it is just a tree. He was under the tree. The Sahaba came to him and they gave the bay'ah under the tree. خلاص. يعني, what is the special in this tree? Nothing. So Umar رضي الله تعالى cut that tree. عن سويد بن النعمان رضي الله عنه وكان من أصحاب الشجرة. يعني البخاري رضي الله تعالى put some of the hadith, maybe nothing related to the غزوة, just he wants to tell us this Sahabi was with them. And why he wants to tell us this? because the scholars رحمه الله mentioned that who are the best صحابة. Okay, يعني for example there are يعني in general مهاجرين المهاجرون better than الأنصار. People who migrated from Makkah to Medina are better than people who were in Medina. العشرة المبشرين, the 10 صحابة, أبو بكر, عمر, عثمان, علي, طلحة, بن عبيد الله, زبير بن العوام, عبد الرحمن بن عوف, سعيد بن زيد, زبير بن العوام, وطلحة بن عبيد الله, سعد بن أبي وقاص. Then they will mention أهل بدر, people who attended بدر, 315. Then people who attended this place, okay, this غزوة صلح الحديبية, 1400. So they need sometimes to mention the name of the Sahabi. Why? To put them in which place? Okay. And this is mentioned, يعني, like the scholars mention who are the best Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, then Ibrahim, and then Musa. So they mention to know the level of each صحابة. وكان من أصحاب الشجرة سويد بن نعمان. سويد بن نعمان was one of those who witnessed the tree, يعني the بيعة under the tree رضي الله عنه. قال, he said, كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أتوا بسويق فلاكو. He said the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and his companions were given سويق and they chewed it, يعني a type of food. It is known that time سويق. So they ate this type of, it is wheat and something like this. They ate this food under the tree. Then من حديث عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله تعالى عنه said I was walking with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم at night. Okay, during that غزوة, maybe they are coming back after, يعني after they came back to المدينة. He said I was walking with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم at night. Okay, because you know, if you want to travel, it is allowed to travel at night. يعني it is not forbidden to, يعني you have to stop after sunset. No, you can't travel. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said عليكم الغدوة وشيء من الدلجة. عليكم الغدوة, يعني use the time of غدوة. What's the meaning of الغدوة? الغدوة, this time, الفجر, early morning. This is the time of بركة. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said اللهم بارك لأمتي في بكورها. Oh Allah, give my ummah baraka في بكورها. بكور means early morning. يعني the scholar said this time is the time of rizq. يعني unfortunately now most of people sleep after fajr. يعني those who pray fajr, يعني الحمد لله they pray fajr, but they sleep after fajr. Yeah, maybe nowadays because Fajr is 5:15 or 5:20, so and you have school, you don't sleep after the school, after the Fajr. But in, let's say in April or in May, Adhan is about 4, so most of people sleep after Fajr, and this is the time of Barakah, the time of Barakah, and that's why we miss this time. A lot of people miss the Barakah with this time. سبحان الله. So he said عليكم بالغدوة. When you travel, take care about this time, بركة. البركة time, الغدوة, which is the early morning, after فجر, immediately. Then he said وشيء من الدلجة. And part of night. دلجة, what's the meaning of دلجة? To walk at night. So it is allowed to travel or to continue. You're traveling at night, okay? But don't walk all the night, okay? Part of the night. Why? The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, فَإِنَّ الْأَرْضَ تُطْوَى بِالْلَيْلِ. Because at night, the earth is shortened at night. Okay, how? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said this. And sometimes, yes, you feel this. When you drive the car at night, if you are traveling, you feel the distance is shorter. SubhanAllah. So he said, I was with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, walking with him at night in this ghazwa. Then I asked him, Umar radiallahu ta'ala, and asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not answer. Then again he asked him second time, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not answer. Then the third time he asked him, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not answer. Then Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu said to himself, Takalatka ummuka ya Umar, may your mother be bereaved of you. نزرت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ثلاث مرات. You asked the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم three times, and every time he did not answer. Then عمر رضي الله عليه وسلم. Then عمر رضي الله تعالى عنه said, فحركت بعيري ثم تقدمت أمام المسلمين. Then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم did not answer me three times. Then what I did? I went in front of the people of the army. I was on a camel, so I enhanced my camel to go in front of the Muslims of the army. Yani he felt that I did a big mistake. I should ask only one time. Khalas. Why am I am repeating? So he was blaming himself. Subhanallah. Then he said, وَخَشِيتُ أَنْ يَنْزِلَ فِيَّ Quranan. I had hardly waited for a moment when and I was afraid that something might be revealed in my connection. Maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reveal something about me, because I made the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam angry. فَمَا نَشِبْتُ أَنْ سَمِعْتُ صَارِخًا يَصْرُخُ بِي. I had hardly waited for a moment when I heard somebody calling me. Somebody called me. I said, I was afraid that something might have revealed about me. So he was thinking maybe Allah will reveal something. Then when somebody called him, خلاص. It is about me. It is an ayah, a verse about me. سبحان الله وجئت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم سلمت عليه. I came to Allah's messenger and greeted him. Then صلى الله عليه وسلم said, لقد أنزلت علي الليلة صورة لهي أحب إلي مما طلعت عليه الشمس. And why he called me, Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, to tell him, لقد أنزلت علي الليلة سورة. Tonight there has been revealed to me a سورة. One سورة. لهي أحب إلي مما طلعت عليه الشمس. Which is dearer to me than all the world on which the sun rises. ثم قرأ إن فتحنا لك فتحا مبينا. Verily we have given you manifest victory. So this hadith, why he put this hadith Bukhari? To tell us that Surah Al-Fath, when you read Surah Al-Fath, what you understand? You understand what happened in the eighth year when the Muslims opened Mecca for Muslim. It became a Muslim country, Mecca. But no, Surah Al-Fath, Allah revealed Surah Al-Fath before that event in 2 years. In which event? In Al-Hudaybiyah. So subhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala considers Surah Al-Hudaybiyah as Fath. It is a victory. يعني مو يعني maybe we mention what happened that صلح when they wrote that the kuffar said to the Muslims this year you should go back, it is not allowed for you to do Umrah this year, come next year and we allow you to do Umrah. If a Muslim, if one of the kuffar became a Muslim, then he went to you, okay? You should bring him back to us, not the opposite. Okay? If one of you became a kafir, you don't have the right to ask for him. So the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala became very angry, very sad. So now they are with ihram. What they can do? Okay, they cannot do the umrah. There is something called al-ihsar, hukm al-muhsar. What's the meaning of hukm al-muhsar? If somebody is forbidden to continue the hajj or umrah, like what happened to the sahaba, the kuffar stopped them. So in this case, what do you do? What you do? Shave your hair or cut your hair and slaughter your sheep. So this is what the Sahaba رضي الله تعالى did. Okay. So, يعني for example, now maybe you go to Mecca, okay, but they tell you that, no, there is something wrong with your passport. Okay, or there is something wrong with your visa. Or there is a disease and will not allow more people to enter Mecca. Yani, something not in your control. So what you do? Shave your head, shave your hair, okay? Or you can cut the hair and slaughter your sheep. Or you can buy a hadi, a sheep, and you slaughter. Then you can remove the ihram and you put on your normal clothes. No, outside, because they were outside. The Sahaba were in Hudaybiyah place. They are not allowed to enter.
But there is a dua, no? Before we proceed from
Umrah. Habasni. Fain habasani. Okay.
By which we can we do not have to slaughter, right?
If you said this. If you said this,
they didn't say this.
Huh?
But this Sahaba, they didn't say this.
The Sahaba did not do this. Why? Because there was no reason to say this dua. Yani, some scholars said, when you say this dua, if you expect something, but the Sahaba did not expect that Mecca, the kuffar, the disbelievers will stop them. Why? Because doing Hajj or Umrah, it is open for anyone. This was the rule. You cannot stop anyone. But subhanallah, for you, no. Yani the rule is khalas. Yani like now the world, subhanallah. You kill the Muslim, okay, normal. Kill Muslims. Okay, but if you touch one of the Yahud, khalas, a big problem. Look the Muslim, what the Muslim do? Subhanallah, okay. You have rules. You apply the rules for everyone except for the Muslim. So the same thing, Mecca. The rule is you are welcome to do Umrah anytime. Also Hajj, during the Hajj time. When the Muslim came, of course they did not expect that they will stop them. So when you say this dua, if you expect that there's something wrong will happen. يعني like one of the Sahaba, lady Sahaba, I think her name is Tuba'a, رضي الله تعالى عنها. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, why you don't want to come with us in Hajj, to do Hajj? She said, because I am sick. So maybe I cannot continue the Hajj. Then he said, حجي واشترطي. Go for Hajj and mention a condition between you and Allah. This is a lamp. What is the condition, or how can I say the condition? You say, لبيك حجا فإن حبسني حابس فمحلي حيث حبسني. Oh Allah, I'm going for Hajj. If something stopped me, then my place or my end point is the place where I were stopped. So if you say this dua and something happened, then what you do? Khalas.
Remove
the ihram, go back. No need to shave or cut, and also no need to slaughter. Okay? So if you are okay, no need to say this dua. Why? Because the Sahaba did not mention this dua. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not teach all the Sahaba say this dua. He said to a special case. You have a special case? Okay. Mention this dua. Okay? You are not sure about your passport. You are not sure about the visa. You are not sure about something. Then mention this dua.
It's better to say this dua when...
If you have something.
No, but now, sometimes we do not know what will...
Okay, say this dua. If you, of course, nobody knows what will happen. Okay, this year, some Kuwaitis, imagine with ihram. In the airport, they reached the airport of Jeddah. They told them, go back to Kuwait. Okay. Kuwaiti people.
Huh?
Yes.
Because they did not take visa.
No, Kuwaiti.
Yeah, Kuwaiti.
Yes, not visa. You mean the certificate of Hajj or Tarkhis.
Tarkhis, yeah.
They don't have Tarkhis. So, they are Kuwaiti. And they were with Ihram. And they reached Jeddah, not by a car.
By plane.
Go back. Yes, this happened this year.
They were strict this time.
Huh? Yes. Because the problem, they don't follow the rules. Or they have the tarkhis, but not the same name. Because sometimes, unfortunately, many hamla, maybe most of them, or all of them, Allah alam, okay, yes, they have the tarkhis. I mean, you know tarkhis, the... Permission, yes, the permission. They have permission. But they have the same number, but not the names. Because they buy the permissions from another hamla. For example, I have hamla, okay, and the government gives me, for example, 100, but I will take only 50 person.
50 yourself.
Okay.
50 yourself.
Then Brother Farooq will ask me, okay, I will buy from you. Yes, he will buy with the different names. Different names. So subhanAllah, they do this every year, but this year they checked the names by the barcode. So subhanAllah, people felt very bad. Okay, why you feel bad? You did not follow the rules. I don't know why people become angry if they hear like these rules. Okay, this is to organize Hajj. Imagine 2, 3, or sometimes maybe 4 millions.
Yeah, 3 million.
Four millions. How you want the everything to be okay? Alaykum salam. Of course, we need to follow the rules, okay, to be organized. Then people will complain. Look how it is dirty in Mina. Okay, why you complain? People don't follow the rules. No place for the toilets. They are not enough. Of course not enough. because يعني they give a certain distance. Yeah, for example, for every Hajj, for every Haji, every person wants to do Hajj, there is, for example, 1 meter square. So how many Hajj you have? For example, 100. So 100 meter square. But because you want money, Hamla wants money. So they will add maybe 30, 40 person. So that's why you will not find good place for you. It is crowded. It is not because of the government. No. They are well organized. But subhanAllah, our Hamla, don't follow the... Yes, really don't follow the rules. So the point is, يعني, so subhanAllah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, خلاص, now this year, we'll not do Hajj, we'll do Umrah. And I mentioned what Umar said. So after that, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to the Sahaba, خلاص, remove your ihram, or before you remove the ihram, slaughter your sheep and shave their hair. None of the Sahaba did. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam became very sad. He went to his wife, Salama, radiallahu ta'ala anha, and then he said, look, the Muslims don't obey me. SubhanAllah, she took it simple. Oh, Rasulullah, go and tell the barber to shave your hair and take your sheep and slaughter your sheep. SubhanAllah, yani, look, sometimes, yani, because of the situation is very difficult, you don't think about simple solutions. SubhanAllah. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَشَاوِرُمْ فِي الْأَمْرِ. And he consults the Sahaba. Yes, you are a prophet. I give you wahya, you have the revelation. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to teach us. You consult your friends. Okay. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did what she advised him. Then the Sahaba, all the Sahaba followed him. Okay? Of course, yani, some of the bad people take this situation to accuse the Sahaba. Look, the Sahaba did not obey them, the Prophet ﷺ. Number one, you have to yani, check what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what he said to them, the first hadith I mentioned to you. The Prophet ﷺ said, you are the best people. This is number one. Number two, the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum, why did not they at the beginning they did not obey? Not because they are disobedience. No, because they maybe there is chance. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, maybe he can will change his mind, maybe something will happen. Yeah, and maybe there is a chance we do Umrah. Not because they disobey. And why they followed the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Because خلاص, when the Prophet ﷺ shaved his hair, it means no Umrah, no way, no chance. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّا فَتَحْنَا لَكَ فَتْحَ مُبِينَ. So this is a very important point. Sometimes you find people very aggressive with the rulers. Or why? Because of some deals with the kuffar. Look what the rulers do, we are weak, what they did. Okay. Sometimes, not always. They don't know the real situation. Like, imagine the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum did not agree with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Or they felt sad when they hear what happened. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala named this Ghazwa, or name this sulh, fat as a victory. And subhanAllah, يعني, maybe I mentioned last time, or maybe two or three weeks ago, the number of people who became Muslim in 2 years, more than the people who became Muslim in 16 or 17 years. So this is the fact, this is the real victory. Sometimes you need to give the kuffar what they want, not because we are weak, but because this is better for us. It's better for us, but you need the wisdom, okay, and also you need to consult the people who have the experience. But the general people not accept anything. Will not accept anything you say. Why? Because they want everything now, like children. Subhanallah, you notice your son, he's 15 years old, I want to drive the car. He will ask you, please give me your key. Sah? Wait. Okay, it is only 3 years. Okay. Why you need the car now? خلاص. I take you to the school and to the jam'iyya. Subhanallah, because they do not have enough experience. Inshallah. حياكم الله. السلام عليكم. عليكم السلام. حياك الله. إن شاء الله. السلام عليكم. عليكم السلام.
The wives are going for picnic with Hayat Tura.
MashaAllah. From his place, Ambur?
No, Bellur he said.
Bellur. Okay. Then he mentioned عن مسور بن مخرمة رضي الله تعالى عنهما قال لما خرج النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عام الحديبية المسور بن مخرمة said when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم went out to الحديبية with the صحابة he mentioned he is not sure about the number okay but we mentioned the number 1400 he came to Dhul Hulayfa. Dhul Hulayfa, this is the place where you start your ihram. Okay? For people, if you go to Medina before Hajj, you have to do ihram here. Dhul Hulayfa. Or another name, Abyar Ali.
Abyar Ali.
Okay? And this is the longest, farthest. Longest. Distance about 400 kilos. Okay. Now it is easy, but at that time it means you will stay maybe for days, 1 week or in Ihram. Yes. At that time it was outside Medina, but now it is inside Medina. Because Medina now bigger. He said, قلد الهدي وأشعره وأحرم منها بعمره. Okay, what he did, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in Dhul Hulayfa, he garlanded his hadi, assumed the state of ihram for umrah from the place, and sent a spy of his from Khuza'a tribe. What is the meaning of taqlid al-hadi wa ish'arihi? Something called taqlid al-hadi. Taqlid al-hadi to put
flowers.
Not flower.
Something.
Okay.
Decorated.
Like the necklace, okay, for the camel, or for the sheep, or for the cow. You know, because the hadi, one of the three. Camels, cows, sheep. Okay, they put, يعني, they mentioned the Prophet put his slippers on the neck of the camel to show them this is for Allah. This is not for me, khalas. This is for Allah. It means you cannot sell your camel after you appoint the animal. It is not allowed. Khalas, this is for Allah, for Mecca. This is the meaning of taqlid al-hadi. Al-ish'ar, what does it mean al-ish'ar? Al-ish'ar, this is only for the camels, not for cows or sheep. Al-sanam, the hump, yes, the hump of the camel, on the right side, you take the knife and you do a small lesion. The blood comes out. Okay, yani it is not very painful for the animal. Yeah, subhanAllah, because you know the camel is strong. Yes, a mark. That this is for Makkah. So when people see this, they respect it. It is known at that time. You should respect this. Don't touch it. Okay? Yani, some of the scholars said you do this for Hajj or Umrah, okay, every time. And other scholars said, no, you do anything to tell them it is a sign that this is for Makkah. And at that time it is known, this is the sign. What, for example, now you can put colors. This is enough, okay? So some of the scholars said it is only to tell people it is a sign, so you can put anything. Other scholars said, no, the sunnah to do this. You do a small lesion and you put something on the neck. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam sent a man Ayn. What does it mean of Ayn? Somebody to spy to see the information, to check. In Arabic language, we say in general for the Muslims or for the good reason, we call it Ayn. For bad reason, we call it jasus. Yes. In Urdu, huh? Jasus. So if the kuffar send somebody for us, jasus. But if we send somebody for good reason, we call it ayn, the eye. Then he came back and said to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, "Inna Qurayshan jama'u laka jumu'a." Okay, Quraysh have collected a great number of people against you. وَقَدْ جَمَعُوا لَكَ الْأَحَابِيشِ And they have collected against you the Ethiopians. Maybe it was known that time they are very strong. Okay. وَهُمْ مُقَاتِلُوكَ And they will fight with you. وَصَدُّوكَ عَلْ الْبَيْتِ And will stop you from entering the Kaaba. Two things, yani. They will not permit for you to do Umrah, then they fight, no. You will not do Umrah, and we will fight. وَصَدُّوكَ عَلْ الْبَيْتِ وَمَانِعُوكَ Then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said to the Sahaba, أَشِيرُوا عَلَيْهِ Oh people, give me your opinion. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said to people, yani, the situation is very difficult now. You are going for Umrah. We don't have the, weapons and everything for battle. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, "Ashiru alayya ayyuha an-nas, oh people, give me your opinion. Do you recommend that I should destroy the families and offsprings of those who want to stop us?" أترون أن أميل على عيالي ودراري هؤلاء الذين يريدون أن يصدون على البيت فإن يأتون كان الله عز وجل قد قطع عينا من المشركين وإلا تركناهم محروبين. Okay, if they should come to us for peace, then Allah would destroy a spy from the pagans, or otherwise we will leave them in miserable state. We'll fight. Okay. Then Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala an said, Ya Rasulullah, kharajta amidan ya ahl al-bayt. Oh Rasulullah, we went out from Medina. Our aim is Kaaba. This house, al-bayt. It means al-Kaaba. To do Umrah. And you don't want to fight anyone. You don't want to kill anyone. And you don't want to fight anyone. فتوجه له كفر كعبة فمن صدنا عن قاتلنا so go to كعبة but if somebody wants to stop us we'll fight him then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said proceed on in the name of Allah أمضوا على اسم الله. يعني like he accepted what Abu Bakr said. خلاص we go to Mecca. If anyone wants to stop us, we'll fight. Okay. One more حديث عن ابن عمر رضي الله عنهما أن أباه أرسله عن عبد الله بن عمر said my father, who is his father, عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله تعالى عنه, sent him in the day of Hudaybiyah to bring a horse for him. It was with another man of Al-Ansar. So يعني they were in Hudaybiyah. So Umar said to his son Abdullah, go and bring my horse from that person. So when Ibn Umar went to bring the horse, he saw the Sahaba under the tree. يعني of course, man, يعني imagine 1,400. They did not give the bay'ah at the same time. Of course, some people will go and they will leave, the other people will come. So it took a long time, man. It is not in 5 minutes. And not all the Sahaba knew at the same time. So at that time, Abdullah ibn Umar and Umar did not know. So when Abdullah ibn Umar went to bring the horse, he noticed the Sahaba giving bay'ah under the tree to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, and my father doesn't know. My father, Umar radiallahu anhu, doesn't know about what the Sahaba are doing. Okay? Then Abdullah ibn Umar, what he did? Did he go to his father or he gave the bay'ah? No, he went to give the bay'ah to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam under the tree. Then he informed his father. Why? Because I want to do. يعني, this is what the scholars mentioned. يعني, look, giving the bay'ah at that time, it is a type of worship, ibadah. The scholar said, يعني, if there is a ibadah, you should compete others. يعني, for example, adhan. For example, if it is the time of adhan, please, who likes to give the adhan? Give the adhan. Then you say, no, you give the adhan. I say, okay, give the adhan. No, you give the adhan. No, this is not the sunnah. For the adhan, for example, you should compete for it. Everybody should look for the adhan. Okay? If there is one place in the first line, please, you go. No, you go. No, this is wrong. You should compete for this place. Okay? So the same thing, Abdullah ibn Umar did not say, I will tell my father, then I do bay'ah. No, I will do bay'ah now. I'll take the chance now. Because, you know, they like to be the first people to do bay'ah.
But as you said, for the place, the first line, now, sometimes we compete, but it becomes a sort of bad manners.
No, يعني, the point is not in a bad way, but يعني, I will tell you what is happening. Okay, there is only one place. Okay, and يعني, there is a second line. Unfortunately, sometimes the second line started, and there is a space. Okay, so you notice two people going, you and another person. So when he noticed you, there's, then you say, no, in this case, if he say, if...
It is politeness.
Sorry?
It is politeness, no?
Don't do this, no. Okay. If he did this for you, if he tell you, you go, then go. Yeah.